Bishop Eduardo Kussala of the Tumbura Yambio Diocese in South Sudan says that while the fragile peace is holding right now, the nation is anxiously awaiting the government's transition in November. The peace deal, brokered in September of last year between the South Sudanese president and the former vice president, ended a civil war that began in 2013. The peace deal is holding for now. What are your thoughts about the stability of South Sudan as November approaches?
The formation, which is supposed to be November 12th, this year, next month, is expected to bring all the parties who are in opposition to be in a government. And this government will be a transitional government, that is a government of national unity, that will be able to build the country towards a proper time for election. But we have a worry that not all of these parties are like going to be part of this formation. And we are praying, urging them that they have really to be part of this formation of the new government so that we are able to have the peace that everybody is looking for. But the conditions surrounding this is a concern, that we're supposed to form one national army, which has to have one commander-in-chief. And this process has been dragging, and that's why our people mm-hmm. have a bit of worry. Tell them, let them talk heart to heart, let them have the human heart to forgive and to think about their people. We, as in the church, we have picked the same role to engage the leaders privately, publicly, and in different ways to encourage them that what the Holy Father did was above those articles of the agreement. But I think he wanted them to go beyond this, to embrace themselves as people of South Sudan, to leave a legacy that will remain forever. People will build peace. So we are working on that as a church and using all methods in order to promote the will of the Holy Father in South Sudan, kissing our own feet by forgiving one another. Poverty is born from the conflict itself. And I just began a process a year ago that where I said the Bible in one hand and the hell on one hand, that we have got to work. But that is not quite enough, because then the people are not able to be free to move to their farms and to do their business. The roads are not open. Services are not there. So we are actually working more or less very much to build peace so that the people can be able to do what they do. But we are receiving insignificant support for this because of the conflict that is going on and the fatigue of the donors as well. And so we are struggling first to build peace, to help people come out of the trauma in which they are, and to make sure that they are able to build a place that they love to live in. I thank the American public and the listeners of the EWTN. I managed to bring out over 10,000 young people who were fighting in the bush, and I've stabilized the region with the support that I've received from many of you. And I would like to ask for the same, that through Sudan Relief Fund, okay, that has been very strongly close to us in helping us, providing emergency support, educational, medicines, and all the necessary formation, even for the churches and the construction of our churches. I really appeal that people of goodwill should help us and also pray for us, yes, so that we are able to handle the situation in which we are.
Bishop Eduardo Kussala, president of the Sudan Catholic Bishops Conference, thank you so much for your time and talking with us.
It's a pleasure. Thank you, too. And remember to pray for us, and we pray for you. Thank you so much.
We will. Thank you so much.